plant the separation pneumatic separation, magnetic separation, current separation, specific gravity. And we'll see that the pneumatic separation takes place by density and aerodynamics. And the separation occurs through the combined action of object of fire, which can lift the lighter material, and the oscillatory movement capable of separating the material which lowers specific gravity from the. And another process is the anti-current separation. And this process is used to separate non-ferrous metals, that is those metals, and including alloys that does not contain iron, and materials fed onto the conveyor belt of the anti-current separator, which moves it across the magnetic rotor, where separation is just stream of material discharged are separated by a splitter, which divides the non-ferrous metal from the non-metallic material, such as paper, plastic, wood, and the key component to the anti-current separator is the magnetic rotor. And when a piece of non-ferrous metal, such as aluminium, passes over the separator, the magnets inside the rotor rotate past the aluminium again, and this forms an anti-current in the aluminium, which in turn creates a magnetic field around the piece. And the polarity of that magnetic field is the same as the rotating magnet, causing the aluminium to be repelled away from it. This repulsion makes the trajectory of the aluminium greater than that of the non-metallic material, allowing the two materials to interface. And here we have a representation of this. This material field, ferrous metal and non-metallic material. And this is the magnet, and this is the part of the process, because it creates a magnetic field rotating past the aluminium, for example, inside this material there is aluminium. And the rotation of the rotor causes a magnetic field around the pieces of because of the aluminium take the same charge of magnetic rotor, there is a safe area. And this revolution causes a bigger trajectory of combined with the other non-metallic material, and so thanks to this different trajectory, it's possible to separate. Questions?
Sorusu olan var mı?
The magnetic separation uses for magnetically susceptible material that are extracted from a moonstone using a magnetic force. The process is applied for the recovery of ferromagnetic metals from non-ferrous metals and other magnetic. Here we have another representation. We always have a magnetic bullet. And the material here is contaminated. We have a quantity of iron, but it's contaminated by topics that the ferromagnetic metals remain attached to the magnetic, while the non-ferrous material, which not doesn't contain ferrous, not, and it is so. Possible to write it because the material which contains iron remains attached a long time for much.
So, so long, right?
Then we have the specific gravity separation. This method is of common practice when the two components, in form of either a suspension or a dry granular mixture, can easily be separated as the specific way. Are significantly different. Any questions?
Sorusu olan var mı?
Now we talk about the aerosol substance. Certain kinds of equipment may contain a substance harmful to human beings and animals. The substance must be removed fluorocarbons, CFC, and hydrofluorofluorocarbons, HCFC, which are responsible of the ozone sphere depletion, and they may be present in the cooling circuits of filters and air conditioners of older generation, or in polyurethane from and other substances containing batteries, cathodes, tubes, and solder, and recycling. And cadmium is found in semiconductors, cathodes, tubes. It's carcinogen and it causes irreversible damage to the critical substance is mercury, which is present in thermostats, medical equipment, and telecommunication devices. It causes severe damage to the brain and the children because they inhibit the mental. Question.
Sorusu olan.
And the treatment of this harmful substance are for CFC and HCFC. The protocols and international guidelines were issued to encourage research and development in the refrigeration sector because of the fire against the ozone hole, and the impact of refrigerants on the environment can be summarized in the following points. And toxicity for humanity and animals, biological and genetic influences, smell, flammability and explosiveness, direct impact on global warming, energy consumption, and potential influence on ozone layer. There are the natural fluids such as ammonia, hydrocarbons, water, and CO2. The criteria for selecting the refrigerant in the future are based on parameters such as energy efficiency, safety, and environmental. It is always one of the most recycled materials in terms of recovery rate, but it can be remelted infinitely to remove impurities. For this reason, recovering and recycling this element is cost effective in addition to being advantageous from the environmental point. Use of recycled meat in the production of brand new products is high energy efficient. Recycled meat production takes only 35-40% of the energy necessary to produce damages.
So this one.
Herkese de bu kurşun araba değil. Yetmiş olarak.
They use mostly another commodity. They use commonly in the recycling of the batteries for the for the cars.
Yes, because recycling the lead is very convenient from all point of view. The presentation of the lead recycling process. So here we have the battery grouping. And from the battery grouping, separated the material like retracables, sulfuric acid, and polypropylene plant. So sulfuric acid and polypropylene go to the specific treatment plants, while lead residues go to the
acid.
It's a kind of plastic. You have a lot of composition from plastic. It's a specific plastic uses for.
Tesisindeki tanklar da bunu kullanıyor. Arıtma tesisinin içindeki tanklar da bunu kullanıyorlar.
Arabın?
Arıtma tesisinin içindeki tanklar da bunu kullanıyorlar.
Okay, they use as well this propylene and retreatment tanks in the car manufacturing plants.
Yeah, I think that is kind of plastic used in automotive industry. You have this kind of plastic, this kind of plastic, but it's different. They have a different treatment. So, but after the process, remelted process, it can be reused for a lot of time in ingots, wire, and other materials. Now, talking to speak about the cadmium. Cadmium will be always present in human society, either used food products or in food. kendimi baktığınızda sensel bilmeliyiz bu arada ilmeğe industriyel enkosyonel particularly those required high power, long cycle glass and low temperature glass. The materials in recyclable nickel cadmium batteries can be more than 99% recovered for use. In the production of new nickel technological point of view, it is important to develop and maintain functional products with long service lives. Once again, to minimize the input into the world's waste stream. The recovery of cadmium from cadmium products for recycling programs not only ensures the cadmium will be kept out of the waste stream and out of the environment, but it helps to conserve its value. Here we have an example of cadmium recycling impact of the picture to the battery. So for lithium carbonate precious, it's possible to create the batteries and throughout some addiction and additive and then the liberation of plastic materials and specification with the battery equipment. And the life cycle of batteries continue with the post-mortem opinion, which in a specialized important to that is natural opening that you have after sometimes because they come to open and release all the acid and which contain into the environment. But for this reason, they have to process in a specialized treatment. And in this treatment plant, there is an extraction of the water. Modern filtration of all irritated like needle and something containing motion with ethanol eliminated the electrolyte recycled. Recyclable materials goes into the thermal instance with an and water that remain are ready to be put into the life cycle, into the cycle, and from the raw material that is used. No, I should look you for YouTube, maybe.
Yeah.
But I don't know how I can put the video on the display.
Okay.
I'm not so good to utilize. Yes, it is about acid, yes, other acid, but the worst thing are the presence of inhibitors that are really toxic. Environment. You speak about the leaks into the environment, the environment, I think, no?
Yeah,
the problem is, yes, because batteries containing a lot of dangerous substance and the worst acid and thermal disruptions with the waste into solid mercury solids and a liquid phase that consists of water, mercury and other pollutants that may be in the waste of product and that evaporate in a certain temperature. The thermal treatment of mercury waste is typically performed at temperatures between 350 degrees to 800 degrees and depending on the chemical composition of the mercury. Another representation of mercury. Mercury is inside, could be inside the fluorescent lamps. After that, mercury is removed from the lamps, they are crushed and the material. There are some materials which compose the lamps that are metal, glass, electronics, and plastics, and they are treated separately. The other components used are mercury, phosphor, copper, bearing are treated through our distillation, which is always technique from this treatment, like an output, we have pure mercury and phosphor and copper. It can separate the pure mercury from the mercury and be put inside the cycle of lab's bodies. from the automobile sector. The main impact associated with the number of automobile sector is that first there are the high energy demand which automobile requires in for all the sector life, cause the crude oil consumption. And the crude oil consumption it causes the emissions of these emissions to air cause climate change, acidification, acidification of rain, and respiratory and other effects. Another impact, big impact associated with automobile sector development is the depletion of non-renewable resources from raw materials.
Otomobil sektörünün çevre üzerindeki ikinci önemli etkisi ise ham madde ihtiyacı için yenilenebilir nitelikte olmayan kaynakların tüketilmesi.
And all this research which at the end of life of car goes into the waste stream and so this increases the waste stream production.
Bu da yüksek atık, gerek atık su olsun, gerek atık katı olsun, yüksek atık ortaya çıkmasına yol açıyor.
So this is important to develop the action to reduce these impacts.
Bu nedenlerden ötürü olası etkileri azaltmak, yani etkileri ortaya çıkan etkileri azaltmak için yapılması mümkün olan çeşitli eylemler yapılması mümkün olan çeşitli alınması mümkün olan çeşitli önlemler var.
Some actions, possible actions to reduce this impact are development of alternative fuel.
Yapılabilecekler içinde şunları sayabiliriz. Alternatif yakıt biçimlerinin, alternatif yakıtların geliştirilmesi.
And this goes to reduce the energy demand.
Bu elbette yüksek enerji talebini sınırlayacak, azaltacak önlemlerden biri olacaktır.
And food limitation, the food consumption reserve.
Bu da ham petrol rezervlerinin tüketimine sınırlama getirecektir doğal olarak.
And another possible option is the substitution of heavier materials with lighter ones.
İkincisi ise kullanılan ağır malzemeleri daha hafif olanlarla değiştirilmesi.
If we use lighter materials into the cars, we consequently have a limitation in consumption of crude oil because the cars need less crude oil to move.
Araba üretiminde görece daha hafif malzemeler kullanılarak üretime gidildiğinde arabaların ağırlığı azalacağına tüketecekleri benzin ve şey miktarı, yakıt miktarı da azalacak. Bu da doğal olarak küresel ölçekte yakıt tüketimini, küresel ölçekte petrol tüketiminin azalmasını sağlayacaktır.
And the other option is the use of recyclable materials. Minimize the depletion of non-renewable resources.
Yapılabilecek diğer bir, atılabilecek diğer bir adımda geri dönüşüme tabi tutulabilecek malzemelerin kullanımı. Bu da doğal olarak ham madde ihtiyacı için yenilenebilir olmayan kaynakların tüketilmesini sınırlayacaktır.
Some question?
Sorusu olan.
Now we have